a blessed Saturday of Lent to us. When we read the text of today's gospel reading, one word tells us something, that there is something new or very new about the teaching of Jesus. And what is that word? It's but, upon. Okay? However, it is not enough to say that this teaching is new. Why? Scholars always investigate about this thing about loving the enemy. In Mesopotamia, in a document called Councils of Wisdom, around 2 millennia, it is also being discussed. And then in Egypt, in the instruction of Amenem Ope, which is, by the way, also the basis of writing the book of Proverbs, that is also the same thing. That's why in the Old Testament, through the book of Proverbs, there is also a mention of respecting or loving the enemies in that particular expression. But what makes Jesus' teaching really radically different? In other words, dili na original si Jesus. Kay mo na gitudlo naman na earlier. But what makes original is his concern. Because these previous teachings about loving the enemy is something like, just do not do something against them. Murabaog, it's more just distance, respect, establish a distance, a gap. Basta wala ang naging mahitabo, kanang gitawag nila og kuan lang peaceful coexistence. But what makes Jesus' teaching new is you have to do something. You have to make an action towards your enemy. And interestingly, St. Gregory the Great, in one of his writings about this, niingon siya nga, ang tendency natong tanan kay makadungog ganit tag na atay dili ganahan o niya na nahagbong ba sa exam or something, mga tawag yun ta, malipay yun ta. And then if there is a person that we do not like and then he is very successful, mag-uulta. No? So unsa may pasabot ana? Okay, according to the teaching, according to Jesus' intention, we have to do something. And not to talk about so many arguments about this, the bottom line here is, you can pray for your enemies, but don't say that, madagma unta na siya. No? Just make what we call a proactive approach, precisely because these enemies we consider, the people we hate, the people we do not like, by the way, are also reflections of the image and likeness of God. Despite their attitudes towards us, and even our attitudes towards them, we are manifesting the goodness of who God is. Muna nga, ani din eh, na ay particular nga distinction nga atong himuon. Well, it is true. It is always a good thing to be respectful. And one more word about the word respect is, respecting is to go beyond what we see in person or in the physical. What we see now, sometimes we do not like, but respecting is to go beyond what we see in that person. And that is the very meaning of the word respect. No, in Latin, it means specto, meaning to see, no, and then re, again, to see again or deeper than what is beyond or behind the person you see. And what is that behind or beyond the person we see? The image and likeness of God. The God whom we have to love, according to the first reading, with all your heart and with all your soul. At every beating of our hearts for as long as we are alive. Because He does that to all of us. He loves us, and so we have to respond to that positively in a way, with Jesus' annotation of doing something, not just avoiding, in order to establish a peace that is non-committal. So proactivity, that is one thing about loving our enemies and praying for our persecutors. Amen.